Disclaimer. This video was intended for an adult audience only. Viewer discretion is advised. Anything you see in this video, do not attempt to recreate. This video was created for documentation purposes only. Our purpose is education. We are not justifying or glamorizing using substances. What we are doing is educating people on the substances that we have used and what it has done for us. Do not recreate or do not redo the substances we have done just because we talk about it.
I made a video about like my shamanic use of these plants and herbs that I use, and I feel like it was a long video, but I really wanted to really talk about real quick about the safety of these things. People need to realize that plants and herbs, it's no different than anything else. There's a safety measure to drinking alcohol, and there needs to be a safety measure to, you know, using plants and herbs. It also should be a common sense thing where it's like, I feel like people should know, you know, that these things are nothing to take lightly. You know, it can be dangerous. You should never just do a plant and herb just because someone says it on the internet. Like, this is not just no disclaimer bullshit. Like, I genuinely believe that because I really think that people need to get educated and become educated before they ever dive into anything. And that means if you talk to your doctor, you can get educated. If you research things online, you can get educated. If you you know, read like journals and reports and studies, you know, on, you know, from college papers, then that, you know, that gets you knowledge. So I just think people need to learn about the things they're getting ready to do and don't just do things just because it seems like the cool thing to do. Especially because shamanic use, I feel like, has nothing to do with trying to get high. I feel like when I mean something can be used as like an empathogen and you can enjoy yourself, I'm explaining the effects and the way it makes me feel, yes. And it is enjoyable, but that doesn't mean that the intention was that I just want to get high and escape my problems. I want to feel good. Whatever. Like, I don't ever want to do something to escape my problems because I've been there, done that. I've used substances to escape my problems. There was a time where I went through a little pill stage. For like 2 months, I was using pills, and I was using them to escape my problems. There are many substances, legal and illegal, that are used to escape your problems. That's why I don't drink alcohol, because I can't find a deeper connection with it. I can't find that deep connection with it. Like, I can't find a soul in it. Because, you know, one of the things that Native Americans used to believe is that alcohol was kind of like the soul extractor. Like, it extracted the soul of the plant. And I heard that they also said that that if there was no soul in the alcohol, like if the alcohol did not contain like a plant soul or a plant's extract, then therefore it would suck your soul. And that kind of stuck with me. It made me think, because I was never a fan of alcohol anyways. Like, I don't like the effects. But it just made me think, right? And this is why I use these things, to connect with the soul of the plant. I use these things to connect to a thing that's much deeper than myself. Plants contain knowledge. And the high that you get from the plant is misunderstood, because all a high is, like I said in the last video, you know, about this. It was like, it's an elevated state of mind, but it's deeper than that. It's the plant's mind. The effects of motherwort, how it's calming and how it, whatever, it's like, that's how motherwort feels. She's calming. She's relaxing. She, like, if she was embodied into a human being, that human being would have the personality of someone who is calm and relaxed and you know, have the traits of motherwort. And that's what I mean by the traits of the effects of the plant, the traits that the plant has, whether it's smell, its effects, its taste, its whatever. I feel like these are basically the characteristics of the plant itself and its personality. And when you take the plant, the high you feel is just, you are now feeling its personality. It is allowing you to feel how it feels and what it feels. And it's allowing you to see the world through its eyes. And it's just, that's just my belief, you know, personally. But this is just what I believe. You know, I've connected very deeply with many plants. And I can say that, you know, I said it before, but motherwort is a deep connection to me. Maybe it's because motherwort naturally grows around here. So it's like, the fact that motherwort naturally grows around here means that the natives that used to live right here used to use motherwort. The same thing with blue vervain. Blue vervain is the next herb that I'm going to be experimenting with. I'm basically kind of, in a nutshell, kind of using the plant dieta, but not really, because, like, because I gotta move, because the phone's about to die, I gotta plug it in, but I'm kind of doing a plant dieta, but not really, because I haven't, I'm not just using motherwort, I'm also using cannabis, you know, small amounts of cannabis, but I think that's just me personally, but basically, I've just been using motherwort, and I've been exploring with motherwort almost every day, honestly, like, almost every day. I take a day or two break every week, but so five to six times a week. Sometimes, most of the time, it's just once a day at night, but it's mainly because I'm doing heavy doses, and it's mainly because of a tolerance thing, because in the beginning, it was a much more stronger effect. I could feel it more. And it's just like anything else, that it builds a tolerance up. And so that's just something I've noticed. And I noticed that it works better when I just only, do it at nighttime. Just do it at nighttime and I take it. And yeah, so I just wanted to make this video real quick, because, you know, I'm not ashamed to say that, you know, I've been going through hard times in my life, and that I'm, you know, kind of using motherwort to help guide me through it. And it's like, instead of using a substance to escape the problems and not think about them, I'm using motherwort to help me think about the problems and to help be with me for these problems and to help, like, kind of make me think of solutions for these problems. Because motherwort allows me to get in a calmer state of mind. It allows me to be more, to feel a little more, and to be more empathetic for myself, and to not be as harsh on myself. And, you know, I don't know, it just allows me to look at myself. And it has also allowed me to see that I've been a little upset and angry for, like, the past, I don't know, month or so. And, like, I don't know. I just realized that it's like, I need to, motherwort's helping me let things go. It's helping me be able to, you know, be comforted through some hard times, moving forward and pushing past. And it's a beautiful, beautiful thing. And yeah, I think plants are conscious. And I think that each plant has a different set of tools to show you. It can, see, there is no magic pill. There is no magic anything. It's just, these things can give you tools, and it's up to you what you do with these tools. Because all these things are tools. They're teachers. They're, you know, things that can guide you, but they cannot do for you. So, that's just, I'm going to leave it at that. But thank you guys so much for watching. And if you guys love herbs like I do, that's awesome. If you're not into herbs, maybe do some research, because herbs have helped me tremendously in my life. You don't got to use them shamanically. Like, I do not recommend people do what I do just because I do what I do. I think that people should use these plants and herbs responsibly, respectfully, and consciously, because they're conscious as well, and they have something to teach if you're willing to listen. But thank you guys so much, and I'll see you guys in the next video.